Good morning, good morning. To God be the glory for the great things he has done. It is a wonderful day that God has kept us, and we tell God thank you. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. We just thank God for a beautiful day. We thank God for awesome church school. We thank God for just allowing us to see another week's journey. And for that, we tell God thank you. Good morning, my sister, Sister Annie Holmes. We just thank God for the many blessings and all that God continue to do. And for all of you who are chiming in, and those, I want you to go ahead and share it. I want you to go ahead and host your watch party. Just go ahead and text somebody and tell them Holy Trinity AME Church is on one more time. And there is a word from the Lord this morning. We greet you in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because if it had not been for him, where would you and I be this morning? But we're just so grateful and so blessed that God found favor in waking us up this morning. And we tell God, thank you. We wish you a wonderful, wonderful experience today as we move forward to do what God has allowed us to do this morning. So we are going to come with an opening selection. And then following the opening selection, I will offer our prayer and our scripture. And then following our prayer and scripture, I will come and give you some church announcements that we need to be made aware of. And then following that, we will then go into our word. Amen. 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 Because there is a word from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord. And we just thank God in advance. Lady Holmes sends her love, her blessings, and her kindness. And we just thank God for her being in the number this morning. And we're just so grateful that God has blessed us once again to be in his presence. And to God be the glory for the wonderful things. So here's our opening selection this morning. And we just trust and pray that you will be blessed as you prepare to hear the word.
Come on, Pastor.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Devil is a liar. Amen. Ah, it's all right. Come on, put those hands together. It's all right. That's, I got to hold my phone. I got to hold my phone. That's all right. Just nod your head.
Jesus said,
ah, bless your God. Ah, oh, God, I need to lean on you, Jesus. Ooh, I won't. Ah, good morning, Sister Joanne. Thank you, God. dear God. Yes, sir. Bless you, God. Good morning, Brother Allison. Woo, thank you, God. Trinity is on. Bless you, God. Bless you, God. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you for another opportunity. We thank you for another day that you've allowed us to come together. God, we speak peace. Right now, God, we just want to thank you for waking us up this morning. And God, not only did you wake us, but you woke us in our right mind. And God, we come to tell you thank you. God, we ask now that you take us out of self and allow your Holy Spirit to dwell within us this morning. God, we ask that you just send your unconditional love, that you send your forgiving love, and that you send all of the mercies and the grace that only you can give, God. We thank you, God, for what you've already done. We thank you for what you are about to do. But most of all, God, we thank you for what you're doing right now, because you didn't have to do it, but you did. And for that, I want to tell you thank you. God bless our sick. We just ask that you continue to strengthen their bodies and that you not have them to be mindful, nor have them to doubt what you're about to do in their lives. God, we just thank you in advance for how you're going to move in this service this morning. And God, it's not of me. It's not of those who are. It's just all about you, God. And we just want to tell you thank you. In advance, we want to tell you thank you in advance. We want to thank you in advance. We want to thank you in advance for what you're going to do. God, I just feel you moving this morning. And I know there's greater. God, I know there's greater thing that's about to come. God, we speak it now and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. And the children of God shall say amen. Oh, God, we thank you. God, we thank you. God. Our scripture this morning comes from Jeremiah chapter 18. Jeremiah chapter 18. Oh, God, I feel good this morning. Jeremiah chapter 18, verses 1 through 6. Jeremiah chapter 18, verses 1 through 6. And you will find these words. Jeremiah 18, 1 through 6 says, the word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and behold, he was doing a work on the wheel, and the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. So he made it again, another vessel, as seemed good to the potter to make it. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, can I not do with you as this potter, says the Lord? Behold, as I lay in this potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. The word of God for the people of God, thanks be to God. Amen, amen. Jeremiah 18, 1 through 6. We just thank God for a wonderful day, and we thank you all for tuning in. Just a few announcements, and we ask that you please govern yourselves accordingly as we move forward. I want to first thank all of you for supporting the ministry this week by attending meetings, by attending Bible talk, by attending our breast cancer awareness forum. Oh, what a mighty blessed time we had this week. So I want to thank you. I want to thank you for doing the great work that you are doing as we minister through this time. I want to remind you that on Wednesday night, we have a Bible talk, and that starts at 7 o'clock p.m. So I want to remind you We want to learn more and study to show ourselves approved. Be mindful that church conference will be held on Thursday, October the 29th, and that will be at 6:30 p.m. Please, all members of Holy Trinity, please be in attendance. We will plan and move forward to higher grounds. You will get that information this week as to what platform, where to contact as we move forward. Please continue. The announcements won't be long, so please continue to invite folks to come on in this worship experience this morning. This afternoon, I will be preaching for James Chapel AME Church at 4 p.m. for their annual tea. If you have Facebook, the information is on Facebook. If not, Sister Gamble will send out a text today after service. Please support your pastor by attending. It will be on Zoom. It will be by Zoom. So for those of you who are on the teleconference call, if you need to know how to get on the Zoom, just text me and I'll send you the meeting number. We will be helping out James Chapel, AME Church, this afternoon with the Reverend Dr. Chris Watkins is the pastor. Charles Watkins is the pastor. And we will be helping them out for their annual tea. I want to once again stress to all of us, please let us go out and vote. I can say let's vote because Pastor has led the way. We ask that you please go early voting, do mail-in ballots, whatever you need to do, because we need to get out and vote. As my deceased fraternity brother John Lewis would say, let's get into some good trouble, because if you do not cast a vote, then you would have forfeited your right to talk after November the 3rd. So please, I plead with you, go out, let's go out and vote. Let's exercise our right to vote. And also, I want to remind us for our Coins for Christ for the 2021 calendar year, I am saving my coins. I tell you, I'm saving my coins. So I need you to start putting your coins aside. And therefore, in September of 2021, we will be able to do what needs to be done. I want to say welcome this morning to, as you know, we had another annual conference, the Central South Carolina Annual Conference on yesterday. And I want to say welcome to the Reverend Marvin Pearsley, who is now the new pastor of Ebenezer Zion on Rifle Range Road. So we say welcome to him, to the Mount Pleasant District. We say welcome, and may God continue to bless the ministry there. We just ask all of you to let us pray ye for one another, because God is still in the blessing business. And I want you to know that God is going to do great things through us and to us if we just call on the name of the Lord, because God is faithful and he's righteous and he's just. And I ask that you just continue to press towards. Let us learn to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. And I want to say to you today, don't you let anybody disturb. I'm talking to me now. Don't you let anybody disturb your peace. Don't you let anybody disturb your joy. Don't you let anybody disturb your relationship that you have with God, because they don't know what it took for you to get it. And you've got to maintain it. Amen. God bless you. We love you. And we just want you to know that it is word time. That's it. It's word time. And we want you to let somebody know. It's word. And I don't know about you, but I need a word. Even though I'm bringing it, I need a word. And I need you to let somebody know that it's word time here this morning. So after we hear, you've got time, because we got a selection coming up. You've got time. Text somebody. Call somebody and let them know that Pastor Holmes, that preacher from Holy Trinity, AME Church on 378 Mathis Ferry Road, is about to let God use him. And so I just want you to get ready. Don't you buckle up. You unbuckle that seatbelt, because I want you to do whatever the Spirit of the Lord says to do. And if it tells you to run, you better run this morning. If it tells you to shout, you better shout this morning. If it tells you to say hallelujah, oh, y'all got me started. And I haven't even started preaching yet. So go ahead and let's just hear this song. And after the song, there'll be a word from the Lord. Amen. Amen. There is a word. I am excited because God's been just that good. Amen. 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 Oh, bless your God. Bless your God. Bless your God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Come on, give him some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. God, you're worthy. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, tell somebody, tell somebody, tell somebody. Woo! God, we praise you this morning. God, we praise you this morning. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for being God. Amen. I'm going to get to the song. I feel good this morning. I just feel good this morning. I feel good this morning. I'm not tired yet. Woo! Shall declare amen, amen, amen. Before we do our prayer, I forgot one announcement that we want to announce to you this morning. We will have our domestic violence and trunk or treat drive through celebration on Saturday. On Saturday, October 31st. On Saturday, October 31st, from 2 until 4 p.m. That will be held. Ferry Road. Please come and support this endeavor. Good to see you, Sister Kim. Good to see you, Sister Kim. Domestic violence and trunk. Bring the children, bring the adults. Everybody just come through. We're going to have some information on domestic violence, and cars will be decorated with their trunks open, and they'll have treats in the trunk. I promise you, we're going to be safe. We're going to make sure from 2 to 4. And also, please be reminded that it is at this time we will distribute our communion during the celebration, so that we will not have to, we can partake it together on Sunday morning. Amen. We're going to come through and also distribute our communion on that same celebration. And for those of you who are normally bringing your tithes and offerings during that Sunday morning, on the first Sunday, we just bring it on Saturday. We'll be ready to receive it, and God will continue to bless us for it. Just wanted to announce that you'll be hearing more about it this week. And we want a big celebration on Saturday as we come and learn and celebrate. Amen. 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 It's word time. It's word time. It's word time. It's word time. I'm not tired yet. Woo! Eternal God, our Father, we thank you. Lord, we ask now that you decrease Arthur and increase who you've called me to be. Send a fresh anointing. God, use me for your service and your glory. And God, as you've done it so many times before, I just ask that you please do it again. And Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Oh Lord, my strength and my redeemer, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Our scripture this morning was read earlier. Look with me to Jeremiah chapter 18. Jeremiah chapter 18. Ah, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. I'm so grateful to see many of you come on this morning. Thank you. We are increasing in our teleconference, and thank those of you who are visiting by Facebook. Please tell somebody that still got time. Jeremiah chapter 18, the scripture that was read earlier, verses 1 through 6. And it says, the word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and behold, he was working a work on the wheels. And the vessel that he made of clay was warped. It was marred. It just wasn't fixed right in the hand of the potter. So he made it again, another vessel that seemed good to the potter to make it. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, cannot I do with you as this potter, says the Lord? Behold, as the clay is in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. We're going to use for our subject this morning, and if you pray with me, I won't be before you long. Our scripture this morning is, I'm going to the potter's house. I'm going to the potter's house. If all of us this morning were to take a serious look at ourselves, we would see that there's something wrong with each and every one of us. As much as we try to cover it up, as much as we try to pretend that it does not exist, as much as we try to hide it from some of the closest people in our lives, there is a flaw in all of us. And we need to realize that there's something wrong with each of us. And as we look in today's society, we see how folks are constantly even in the midst of this COVID-19, they're having surgeries done to this part of their body and that part of their body to make it look just right and perfect. Well, I just thought I would stop by this platform to remind you that you can work on the outer body all you want, and it's just made out of dust. But if you make yourself appear to be beautiful, handsome, gorgeous, and you need to begin working on the inside. Can I get a witness this morning? You see, the inside has a way of making a difference on the outside. And I wonder if you've ever had an opportunity to meet someone who, in your eyes, for the first time you met them, they were good looking, they were attractive, they were beautiful, they were gorgeous. You thought they would have been the nicest person in the world. But the more you got to know that person, you realize that because their ways were so ugly, it made them an unattractive person. And then you met some people according to what society says. They may not have been the best looking person. Oh, help me, somebody. But when they walked in the room, their them some beautiful persons. And well, I've come to remind you this morning, it's not too late for anybody. You can take a trip with me to the potter's house. And I want you to know there's some people that needs to go to the potter's house, and they need to run right now. There's some folks in leadership this morning. There's some folks, oh, help me, Holy Ghost. There's some folks in the pulpit this morning. Oh, bless your God. There's some folks who are in the midst of what they're going through. They need to go to the potter's house. And just because you have positions, and just because you got titles behind your names, and just because you think you're this and you think you're that, I've come to tell you all of us have some stuff in our lives that we need to go back to the potter's house. Our scripture today finds us talking about Jeremiah. And we all know the most famous quote Jeremiah made was in reference to how having the goodness of God on the inside. Jeremiah said it was like fire shut up in his bones. And one day Jeremiah received a word from the Lord, and it required him to go to the potter's house. Well, Jeremiah, being a humble prophet, that he went down to the potter's house. Or y'all better call somebody up. And he went down so that he could receive a message from the Lord. And when he got to the potter's house, the potter was working on the wheel. But however, Jeremiah noticed that the pot that was on the potter wheel was marred. It was messed up. It was torn up. Oh, it might have been Arthur Holmes. In other words, it was so messed up. It had dents and it had some curves. So instead of throwing it away, help me, Holy Ghost. Instead of throwing it away, the potter shaped it into another pot. Don't you know that some people in your life, because you messed up one time, they threw you away? Don't you know that some people, because they said the wrong thing at the wrong time, they walked out of your life? There's some people who thought you weren't what they thought. As long as you could supply, I'm getting in your business now, as long as you could supply the money, as long as you could supply the Hennessy, as long as you could supply the cognac, as long as you could supply the Budweiser, as long as you could supply the Bud Light, as long as you could cigarette, the weed, the crack, and the cocaine. Y'all know I'm talking, right? They stayed up in your house. They stayed up in your face. They stayed up in your business. But the moment the Lord changed your life, and instead of giving them material things, you started telling them about the goodness of Jesus, they separated from you. But I come to tell you this morning, I'm running for my life. I've got to tell it. I'm not tired yet, because I'm on my way to the potter's house. Preacher, what do you mean you're going to the potter's house? You're a reverend. You're a reverend doctor. What do you mean you got to go to the potter's house? Don't you know titles going to send some folks to hell? Don't you know some folks, because they think they're pastors, they think they can dictate to people? But I've come to tell you this morning, you better learn to have a heart of compassion. You better learn to love God's people. You better learn how to treat people. You better, because I don't care all the money you have, it won't save your life. I've come to tell you this morning, you can have all the knowledge you want, but if you don't know how to treat people, you need to go to the potter's house. We all got some bents. We all got some curves. We all got some scratches and some rough spots. But I've come to tell you, if you listen to the words of the Lord, it's time to take a trip to the potter's house. Let me remind you of this. Every one of us want to be accepted by somebody. And all of us would like to know that someone likes our company. But I come to tell you, there's some folks, if they're not the head, they don't want to be a part. There's some folks, if they're not the chief person, they don't want to be in charge. But I come to tell you, be careful, because Romans says, for I say though through the grace given unto me to every man that is among you, not to think highly of himself. We ought to think sober, because God has dealt to every man the measure of faith. Stop trying to measure what I'm doing with what you're doing. Come on, somebody. We think because we're on the choir singing, but let me tell you, if there wasn't a sexton to open the door, you couldn't get in the church. Come on, somebody. If there wasn't a clean person to clean the church, you wouldn't have clean pews to sit on. So you better stop thinking because you got a title or a position that your life is in order. I come to tell you that we all sin and fall short of the glory of God. So is there anybody other than me needs to go to the potter's house today? Is there anybody other than me who needs to say, Pastor, slow your roll, because I need to catch up with you? Is there anybody here need to go to the potter's house? Because I want to say like David said. David said, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. If any one of you, I need at least 7 to 10 people who willing to walk with me this morning. How many ready to go to the potter's house? Well, Pastor, why are you going to the potter's house? Why you want to get back on the wheel? Well, I'm taking a trip to the potter's house because some of us need to know how to love one another. I want to remind you that some people don't love anybody but themselves. They're selfish. Oh, God help me with that one. They always choose. They always complain about themselves. They come with stipulations, and some people are just selfish. They always want. They never want to give. They always want. They never want to give. Don't you know that with your hands closed, you may not lose that dollar, but you can't get one either. How many of you know that you got to learn to be a blessing to somebody? You know love is an action word. You can tell me you love me all you want, but unless you show me, you're just saying with your words. Come on, somebody. We need to go to the potter's house, because if you love people, we'll stop all this gossiping. If you love people, you stop all this backbiting. If you love one another, you'll stop trying to kill each other. If you love one another, you'll stop thinking it's all about you. If you love one another, you'll try to hold on to God's unchanging hand. If you love one another, instead of talking about me, you'll be praying for me. If you love one another, you'll say, if I can help somebody as I pass along the way. We got to be a loving church. We got to love one another. We got to say, living for God, I'll die. How can you be in church? Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. All shouting up and down the aisles, running from here or there, and you hating one another. The devil is a liar. You better go to the potter's house, get your behind on the wheel, because you need some more love. Folks might say, how, Pastor? You know, you know folks scandalizing your name. You know folks saying mean things about you. How can you love them? Well, I've learned to love the hell out of some people, because the same folks, oh, if I could give a testimony this morning, the same folks that tried to set me up, the same folks who tried to do harm to me, the same folks who said that I wouldn't be mounting nothing, the same folks who went to my superior on me, the same folks who tried to put stumbling blocks in my way, the same folks had to turn around and come and ask me for a favor. I want you to know this morning, when you love one another, whom God has blessed, no man can harm you. The second thing, when you go to the potter's house with me, you learn how to forgive one another. It bothers me. There's some folks who don't know how to forgive. And let me tell you something now, because I'm gonna bless somebody this morning. Just because I don't hang with you don't mean I haven't forgiven you. But sometimes when I forgive you, I got to move on. Because if all you do is stir up mess, if all you do is stir up trouble, if all you do is stir up strife, I don't want to be around you. Oh, come on, somebody. And all I can do is ask God to help you, because what you don't realize is that you're sicker than you think. What you don't realize is that you need more help than you're asking for. Some of us walk around here as if we're doing God a favor, but you better stop in your tracks and you better say, Father, forgive me, for I've sinned and I've fallen short of your glory. I need to go to the potter's house, because if I didn't say it, I thought it. If I didn't think it, I said it. If I didn't think nor said it, I did it. So that's why I need to ask God to forgive me. Some of us need to say, preacher, create in me a clean heart, God, and renew in me the right spirit. I'm on my way to the potter's house. Some folks will put stumbling blocks in your way, but when God forgives you, some of you walk around here judging folks, saying who got this and who don't have that. Well, you better be careful, because St. Luke, the 6th chapter, oh, I feel like preaching this morning. And the 37th verse is, judge not, and ye shall not be judged. Condemn not, and ye shall not be condemned. Forgive, and you shall be forgiven. I'm going to the potter's house so I can get some forgiveness. Some folks want to be forgiven, but they don't want to forgive you. Last time I checked, which was this morning, the Lord's Prayer said, forgive us as we forgive those who trespass against us. We need to learn to forgive people. I'm glad that forgiveness is easy as you make it. Can I get a witness? I'm so glad that the Lord forgave me. I wonder, does anybody here today who did some wrong stuff? But guess what? God forgave you. Forgiving your brothers and your sisters can make life easy. Can I get a witness? When you don't forgive, you hold on to that anger. So why not come with me to the potter's house? Yeah, let the potter put you on the wheel. And if the potter put you on the wheel, I got a feeling that everything is going to be all right. If the potter put you on the wheel, I got a feeling that joy bells will be ringing. I got a feeling that the angels will be singing. I got a feeling if I get on the wheel, I'll live better. If I get on the wheel, I'll work better. If I get on the wheel, I'll serve better. If I get on the wheel, I'll be more faithful. If I get on the wheel, all these ailments that I have, God's gonna heal me. If I get on the wheel, he'll make everything all right. If I get on the wheel, I'll look better. If I get on the wheel, I'll shout better. If I get on the wheel, I can tell everybody, look where the Lord has brought me from. Can I get a witness? If I get to the potter's house, I got a feeling that everything, woo, is going to be all right. Won't he do it? Ah, how many of you know he's already worked it out? How many know he's working it out right now? Somebody know he's working it out right now? Ah, I need somebody to agree with me. Come on, is he working it out? Isn't he working it out? Isn't he working it out? Come on and get on the wheel. Come on, get on the wheel. Come on, get on the wheel. Don't you know he's a wheel in the middle of a wheel? Come on, get on the wheel. I'm going to the potter's house. Is there anybody here who needs to go to the potter's house? I don't know about you. There's some folks. Some folks said things would never make it. Some folks said that you won't amount to much. But aren't you glad? Aren't you glad that when you get to the potter's house, God works everything all right? I'm getting ready to close now, but it tells me one of my favorite nursery rhymes. It went a little bit like this. Can I close with this? The nursery rhyme went a little bit like this. It said, Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king horses and all the king men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty together again. I don't know who Humpty Dumpty's king was, but because he was broken and bruised, he was crumbled beyond recognition. But as for me, Arthur Holmes sat on the wall. Arthur Holmes had a great fall. But just one man named Jesus, he came and he put Arthur Holmes back together again. And since that day, I'm going to run on and see what the end going to be. Since that day, I got more love in my heart. Since that day, I got more joy in my spirit. Since that day, I don't let folks worry me. Since that day, I know that trouble won't last always. Since that day, better days are coming. Since that day, I've been delivered. Since that day, I've been set free. I'm going to the potter's house, because when I get to the potter's house, everything is going to be all right. I can't sing like an angel. I don't try to preach like Paul, but I can tell you, if you go to the potter's house, God will turn things around. Won't he do it? I said, won't he do it? Y'all don't want to pray with me, but won't he do it? Won't he do it? God will. Come on and go to the potter's house with me. Come on and go to the potter's house with me. And I don't know what you're going to say when you get there, but when I get to the potter's house, Guess what I'm going to say? Guess what I'm going to say when I get to the Potter's house? When I get to the Potter's house, I'm going to have a testimony. When I get to the Potter's house, I'm going to have a testimony. When I get to the Potter's house, I'm going to say, trouble don't last always. Come on and go with me. Come on and go with me. Come on and go with me to the Potter's house. Yeah, I'm going. Come on and go with me. But I'm going to the Potter's house. Yeah. He'll do it. I'm going to the Potter's house. Because when I get to the Potter's house, because I call Jesus my rock. Yeah. Come on, go with me to the Potter's house. Pack up your stuff. Come on, let's go to the Potter's house. If you go to the Potter's house, everything is going to be all right. God will wipe all tears from your eyes, but you got to go to the Potter's house. Woo! Woo! I'm going to the Potter's house. I'm going to the Potter's house. Yeah. If my wife don't want to go, that's all right. If my children don't want to go, that's all right. If my best friend don't want to go, that's all right. If my church don't want to go, that's all right. But I'm going to the Potter's house. Yeah. There's victory at the Potter's house. Woo! There's joy at the Potter's house. There's deliverance at the Potter's house. There's a breakthrough at the Potter's house. There's a deliverance at the Potter's house. Yeah. Come on with me. I'm going to the Potter's house. And if I get to the Potter's house, woo, I know God will. God will. Sister Kathy, God will. God will. Put me back together again. Woo. I've been hurt. But I'm going to the Potter's house. Woo! Woo! Yes, he will. Yeah. Woo! Come on and go to the Potter's house with me. Woo! Woo! I want you to know today that you can come to the Potter's house. There's nothing that you've done that you can't go to the Potter's house and ask the Potter to help you again. How many of you ready to go to the Potter's house? Let's take a trip to the Potter's house. the potter can put you on the wheel and put you back together again. The potter wants to put you back together again. The potter can. The potter will. But you got to know that Jesus is your rock. You got to know that without a shadow of a doubt, if I go to the potter's house, everything is going to be all right. Don't you leave this service today knowing that you've not given yourself the opportunity to call on the name of the Lord. Because he says, seek ye me now while I can be found. And the joy of the Lord can be your strength.
Dreams and visions shattered. You are broken inside. You don't have to stay.
You don't have to stay
in the shape that you're
in.
The potter wants to put you back.
Yes, the potter wants to put you back together again. I know it seems difficult. I know it seems rough. But guess what?
Your situation has turned upside down.
God is able today.
And all that you've accomplished.
This is nothing that I play with. This is no joke. This is God's way of saying, I'm calling you to the potter's house. Don't you let this moment go by. If you desire prayer this morning, don't leave, don't leave, don't leave, don't leave, don't you leave. Don't you leave. You are on the verge of a breakthrough. Don't you leave. God is about to do something. God is about to change something. That's what we've been trying to do it ourselves, but it's time to go to the potter's house. It's time to go to the potter's house, because if you go to the potter's house, God is going to do it. God is able to do it. God is able to take your broken heart. Sister B. Austin, know what I'm talking about. God is able to take your broken heart, and God can put it back together again. And even though tears may fall and things may come your way, God is still able to do exceedingly and abundantly. Yes, the potter wants to put you back together again. Licentiate Anthony Taylor, the potter says, come on, let's go to the potter's house, because the potter wants to put you back together again. Sister Anthony Wade, the potter wants to put you back together again. Wants to put you back together again. Mother Dupree, the potter wants to put you back together again. But you gotta call on the name of Jesus. People are waiting to pray with you. 843-509-2427. All you gotta do is call on the name of Jesus. How many of you need to be put back together today? You may not be broken as some of us, but maybe you got some chips and some scars and some bruises. You got some upsets and some downsets. You've got some issues that you're just saying, Lord, have your way, have your way. But the potter wants to put you back together again. Some of you got financial despair. Some of you got health issues. But guess what? The potter wants to put you back together again. The potter wants to put you back together again. Don't you give up on God. Because God will never give up on you. The potter wants to put you back together again. Some of us are broken because of what people have put us through. Some of us are broken because of what people said to us. Some of us, that's it, Sister Dennis. It's the last quarter. Hashtag last quarter. It's the last quarter of 2020. And I tell you, God is about to turn some things around. God is about to make some folks who were the tail, he's about to make them the head. God's going to do something between now and the end of the year. God's going to do it. 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 I don't care what man says. I don't care how much. Y'all know. I don't care how much he says he's going to do this. He can't do nothing without God. God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ask. I want some of you to stop carrying this stuff around. It's time to go to the potter's house. Stop carrying this burden. Stop carrying this weight. Stop carrying this sick situation. Take it to the potter's house. I'm ready to go to the potter's house. I'll take you with me. I'll hold you by your hand if you want to go to the potter's house. Because if you go to the potter's house, you will not leave like you came. If you go to the potter's house, you won't leave like you came. If you go to the potter's house, whatever is bothering you this morning, God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly. Woo! I have not because I ask not. But I'm going to the potter's house. I'm going to the potter's house. Are you going with me? I'm going to the potter's house because I need the potter to put me back together. I need the potter to put me back together. We're going to pray. 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 And I need, I believe God. I believe God. I believe God. I'm with you. I'm with you. I believe God to do it. I believe God to do it. If you're not able to join hands with anybody in your house, I just want you to put both of your hands together. And just ask God now, Lord, I'm coming before you. I'm coming before you, Lord. I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm coming before you. And we're going to pray. And nobody knows like you what you need. And I want you to know that there's nothing hard for God. Preacher, why are you pleading with us? Why are you? Because I want you to go to the potter's house. I want you to get on the wheel and I want you to just ask God to do a new thing in you. Get rid of that junk. Get rid of that guck. Get rid of that stuff that's been holding you back. Stop letting fear bother you. Open your own business. Woo! Sow a seed. If you want to sow a seed in this ministry, if you want to sow a seed in this ministry, they'll put it up on the screen. Go to our Facebook page. Some of you, you all know who want to bless this ministry. Bless this ministry. It's not about me. But I want God to allow you to come to the potter's house. No, it's not T.D. Jakes' potter's house. I know a house that's better than T.D. Jakes' potter's house. I know one that's, you don't have to be in Texas to get there. You can be wherever you are and you can go to the potter's house. Come on, we're going to go to the potter's house. I know somebody's feeling it right now. I can feel it. I can feel it. Somebody's being blessed right now. Lord, why are you putting so much on me? Why am I having so much to deal with? Why am I going through the day that you're going through it? Because the Lord wants to put you back on the potter's wheel. Woo! And in order to get through what you got to get, in order to get to it, you got to go through it. But victory is already yours if you go to the potter's house. One of my technicians, you put the information up there for the cash app. You put the information up there. And those of you who know you send it to me and I send it to the church, you know. But I want you to know this day that you can go to the potter's house. And Holy Trinity can be your potter's house. You don't have to worry about anybody else. This is a personal decision. Stop letting people steal your joy. Stop letting people upset your nerve. Stop letting people let you lose your cool. I'm talking to me now. Because when I come back from the potter's house, I'm going to have peace that far surpasses all understanding. When I come back from the potter's house, I'm going to be healed by his stripes. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, the creator of all good and perfect gifts. God, we thank you for a blessed service. We thank you for sending your anointing. We thank you for allowing us to feel your presence, allowing us to know that you are God. Thank you for showing up today, God. Thank you for taking us to the potter's house. Start with me, Lord. Start with me, Lord. Start with me, Lord. Search this heart of mine. If you find anything that's not right, cast it out right now, God. God, I want to be right. I want to be real. I want to be holy. I need to get on your wheel, God. I need to get on your wheel. I need to get on your wheel. I need to get on your wheel. God, I need to get on your wheel, and you just have your way. I am the potter. You are. I am the mold me and make me after your will, God. God, hallelujah. I want more of you and less of Arthur. I want more of you and less of Arthur. Because God, if you bless me, I'll serve you. God, I want to serve you. Bless the sick and shut, and bless those who are hurting. Bless those who are disabled. Bless those who stand in need of a blessing. And God, if you bless us, we'll be so ever careful to praise you. And God, we know that the battle is not ours. It is the Lord's. And God, we tell you thank you. We tell you thank you. And God, we declare that it's already done. It's already done. It's already done. God, we thank you in advance. It's already done. It's already done. We'll be so careful to give you the praise. God, we know who you are. We want to go to the potter's house. In your name we pray. And the children of God will say amen. I want you to be a blessing to this ministry. Go to our website, find a way to give, be a blessing to the ministry. Also, we invite you to join us this afternoon, hallelujah, at 4 o'clock as we minister at James Chapel AME Church by Zoom. God, I'm going to the potter's house. And I got a feeling that I got some folks who are going to the potter's house with me. I don't believe I'm going by myself. I don't believe I'm going by myself. I don't believe that I'm going by myself. I'm going to the potter's house, and I want you to go with me. Sister Hagamba, put up there how the cash app. Your brother Graddick, put the cash app up there for them. Put the cash app. One of you put it up there for them. But let's go to the potter's house. And I promise you, if you go to the potter's house, he'll put you back together again. He'll put you back together again. We'll see you Wednesday night on Bible Talk. And then please, I want everybody from as far as you can drive to come next Saturday from 2 to 4. Come on, spread the word. Come on and spread the word. We want you there because we want to celebrate. We're going to be safe. We're going to be distant. We're going to be masked. You won't get out your cars. They're going to be handing you the treats of the Lord. Come and be with us. And let me just say this before we go today. I don't desire to be famous. I don't desire to have my name in lights. I just want to live so God can use me. If you want to be a blessing to somebody today, why don't you just shout hallelujah? And if you can't say it on Facebook, just put up a heart. If you want to be a blessing to somebody today, if you want to be a blessing, I know you got to go. I know you're ready to go. But I wonder, do you want to be a blessing to somebody today? Just put a heart up and say hallelujah from the teleconference. Don't you be afraid. If you want to be a blessing to somebody today, say, Lord, make me be a blessing. Lord, use me to be a blessing. Oh, God, I just want to be a blessing. God, I just want to be a blessing. Lady Holmes and I love you. The peace of God be with you. And I'm telling you right now, I'm not turning around because I know I'm on my way to the Potter's house. Sister Delissa, I love you, darling. I praise God for you. Sister Raven, we're going to make Saturday the best that God would have it to be. And folks will be blessed when they leave us because it's more than just a program. It's a ministry. God bless you. God bless you. I love you. And I thank God for you. Until we meet again, I need y'all to do this. Ooh, I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you all. Ooh, God, I love you. God, help me to serve your people. God, help me to serve your people. Woo, keep me humble, God. Yeah, Lord. Yeah, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to the Father's house. I got some imperfections, but when I get there, he's going to make everything all right. Because I'm going to fight on until I get to the Father's house. Y'all, I'm trying to stop. I'm trying to turn off. I'm trying to finish this thing because it's after 11 o'clock. But I feel good in my sanctified soul. I feel good in my sanctified soul. I feel good in my sanctified soul. Woo! Woo! God bless each of you. I know that I love you. And I'm going to fight on. Because I'm going to the Potter's house. Woo! Y'all, I gotta go, I gotta go! I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go, but I don't wanna go. Woo! God bless you.